नमस्कार, हेलो एंड वेलकम टू आवर स्पेशल लाइव फोन इन प्रोग्राम वेबिनार। दिस इज अ 10-day ट्रेनिंग। वेल, CIET NCERT इन कोलैबोरेशन विद अटल इनोवेशन मिशन नीति आयोग ब्रिंग्स टू यू द ऑनलाइन ट्रेनिंग और डिजिटल गेम डेवलपमेंट। Today is the third day of this 10-day training, and today the topic is programming blocks in Scratch. Our experts, they explained to you in the first and the second session how to download Scratch, and he also explained to you how to use Sprite. Well, today we are going to understand programming blocks in Scratch. Please attend this training. Like I said, today is the third day of this 10-day training, and there'll be a theme-based assignment at the last day. Last day, that will be the 16th of July. And on 16th of July, the instructions regarding the same assignment will also be given. So you can submit your assignments, and based on the assessment of these assignments, your certificates will be issued. So happy learning to you all, and spread this message to everyone whosoever is interested in this game development, digital game development, so that you can also join this training, register yourself and get the certificate. And if you have missed the earlier sessions, the first and the second day, then they are available on our YouTube channel, NCERT Official. You can watch those sessions. They have already been uploaded, and every session gets uploaded over there, so you can watch it later as well. We have two experts with us. Let's meet them. And we have with us Mr. Neeraj. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sir is a lead consultant at Learning Links Foundation, and along with him we have one more lead consultant from Learning Links Foundation, and she is Ms. Chitra NJ. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay, so these experts are going to explain the programming blocks in Scratch. Let's begin and let's ask them, sir, what is it that we are going to learn in today's session? Also, ma'am, would you like to explain in a nutshell what we did in yesterday and day before yesterday's class?
Definitely. In continuation with AGR Game Development Platform, brought to you by Niti Aayog and Atal Innovation Mission, implemented by Dell Technologies and LLF, today we will be going through change slide, please. Programming blocks in Scratch, where me and Neeraj sir will be explaining why there are multiple different programming blocks available in Scratch and what are their functionalities. Also, I'll be briefing on yesterday's session. In yesterday's session, what did we learn, what exactly these sprites are, and etc. And also today we'll be seeing an introduction on programming blocks. As I said, there are different kinds of programming blocks that we'll be using, and where exactly we should use, what is the logic behind them, what we can do with those different programming blocks. And as I said, there will be motion blocks, look, sound, even control sensing operators and variable blocks you can add to your animation games or projects, STEM project, anything, and create anything of your own, which is amazing. Also, finally, we'll have fun as homework that will be given at the end. In the yesterday session, we saw what are exactly sprites are. Those are our characters or the objects that we add to our project. Any game or any project that you want to create, you need a character or you need an object to be there, right? So here we call it as sprites. And we also saw how to add these sprites to our projects and the different ways to modify the existing sprites. I mean, the sprites will be already there in the library, or you can paint them, you can take it from online, you can click the pictures of yourself or the other things and upload it on sprites. And also the backgrounds matters a lot, right? So whenever you're creating your animations and projects, you want the backgrounds to be different every time. So how can you do it? Even that was explained yesterday. And role of coordinates, as I said, technically we have longitude and latitude to explain where exactly we are. Just like that, we have our sprites. If you want a sprite to be in a particular position, or if you want the sprite, if, for example, we have a fish which has to start from the right end, how will we do that? We don't know, right? In Scratch, we have the solution. How will we do that is we have X and Y coordinates, where those things helps us with telling if X and Y position given, the sprite will start exactly at this position. So that is the advantage of Scratch and its coordinates. And adding sounds, you can add the sounds which are already available in Scratch. Not only that, you can also add this sounds of your own. You can, like yesterday we had a question, can we create Scratch programs or projects, games in our native languages? Yes, by using sounds. You can add your own sounds of your native languages and create Scratch programs of your own. So this was all that we studied yesterday. If you have missed it, you can go back and check it on the YouTube channel of NCIT.
So, hi. So, in today's session, yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir, please continue with the next.
So, in today's session, we are going to learn about programming blocks. What exactly the meaning of programming blocks and how we can use these programming blocks to design animated stories, games, and animations. So here on my screen, you can see like we have different types of programming blocks in our Scratch. I think you are familiar with one of them. Like we have in the previous two sessions, we have used some type of blocks. Like we have used motion block, we have used sensor block, we have used operational block, we have used variable, sound, control. So here, every block have its own function, right? So suppose if I want to move a picture, if I want to move a background, if I want to move a character, anything if I want to move, so I'll use a particular block, and every block have their own function, right? If I want to add sound, then I have to use the sound block. If I want to make a calculator, suppose if my project is calculator and I want to do some algorithms, I want to do some plus, minus, multiplication, division, then I have to use a block, and the name of the dead block is operation block, where I can do any operations related to mathematics. Suppose I want to add, I want to subtract, I want to check who is the greatest number, who is the smallest number, is the two numbers are equal or not. So these types of functions we can do by using the operation block. So here we are going to, in this session, we are going to learn about all these blocks, right? So here you can see, as I mentioned, motion, look, sound, operation, variable, operations, and sensing. So we are going to learn in detail about these blocks. So using blocks to code your game. So let's learn here. So what do different block shape mean Scratch? We have seen in our software, in the offline, in online software, that we have different types of blocks having different shapes. So what exactly the meaning of the shape? So starting from the first, if I say, you can see there's a black picture. It's basically a shape and it looks like a head shape. We wear a hat, so it's like looking like a head shape. Basically, these blocks are used for whenever I want to start a program, I want to start a script. So that on that case, I use these types of blocks. What is your term?
The second block, which looks like, you know, the C-shaped one. This is used whenever we need a loop. For example, you want any action to be repeated multiple times. How will we do it? We will use this block, put inside all the other blocks that we want to be repeated inside it. So that is how you create a repeat or a loop in your project. For example, any action that you want to be repeated multiple times, for example, 10, 20, 30, or infinite times, that is how you do it by using this particular shaped block.
So here you can see the third block, that is the stack block. Basically, stack block we use to making a stack. You know, stack, like when you are attaching one by one blocks. So here you can perform the main commands. Basically, we use the stack block to perform the main commands. In the next slide, we'll show you how we can use these blocks.
Yeah, the next block, which looks like this, the fourth one, is a reporter block. For example, you have to do mathematical operations, or you want anything in your project to be sensed depending on the maths, then you can use this. With the values that you put inside, it will store it. For example, you want a person to give just numbers. For example, you are doing addition project. Okay, if two numbers are given by anybody, it should start calculating value. in this particular block, and then you can use another kind of the similar block, and you, and your project will automatically gives you the output. So whenever you want to store the values that you're giving as an input, or which is already has been used as an input, this is the block that we use.
So here you can see the next block that is look like a cap. Basically we call it cap block. Why? Because it looks like a clap, and side by side it ends the program. Whenever I want to end my program, whenever I want to close or we can say end the program, so I use the cap block to end the program.
And finally, we have Boolean blocks. They are conditional blocks. For example, it's either 0 or 1 or null, or you know, either true or false. Whatever the conditions that you have given, if that is satisfying, then another action should happen. If that is the case, the project will jump to the next level, go back to whatever it was doing. So we have seen several such examples in our lives, and whenever we are coding, right? So while doing any Boolean functions, when we are using true or false to create any action based on the action that is happening in the previous programming, then we use this particular block. So all of these coding blocks are available on Scratch. Now we'll see what are the different what are the different blocks that are available in Scratch in the real application?
Sure. So you can see on your screen that we have, now we are going to discuss about in detail about the different blocks that we have discussed here. Like first, if I say about the motion block and loop block. So I'll share my software screen, and you can see here, just a second, I'm going to share my Scratch offline software screen. Yeah, now here you can see we have some different type of circles here. Different colors of circles are here, like some are blue, green, orange, pink, blue, light blue, green, you know. So these are the blocks that we are talking about. So starting from the first is a motion block. So when I click the motion block, you can see we have different size of blocks are available here. And as you have seen that some of the blocks we have already used earlier. Humne kuch games pehle banayi thi, and we have already used these type of blocks in our previous sessions. For example, if I take the move 10 steps, you already know ki move 10 steps ka means ki you have to, the character should have to move 10 steps ahead or 10 steps beside side. So is tarah se hum, we can use different blocks. Like here, one is the go to random. Go to random position means whenever I click option, my sprite will move at any random position. So it moved to at any random position. Now, if I want to set my sprite at a particular location, suppose I use this block like go to X. Here, what I have to do, I have to put the location. Suppose if I'm using the graph and I want my character or sprite to go to this position, then I have to insert the value of X and Y. So that same part we have already discussed in the previous session. So if I just slide it down, so you can see we have more options related to motion, like change Y by 10. So I'll delete these blocks. Now I'll show you what is the meaning of change Y by 10. Change Y by 10 means change the direction of Y. So this is the Y axis and this one is the X axis. Now I want my sprite should move its place by 10 steps. So it, whenever I click the this block, see the sprite is moving toward positive Y. And if I write here, if I put a sign of negative, that means my Y sprite is moving towards down direction. So this is how you can use these blocks in your programming. So we have multiple number of blocks in our Scratch. It just how much you are practicing on this software. Agar aap jitna zyada practice karenge, aap itne hi zyada iske bare mein familiar hote jayenge. Right. So there are unlimited blocks are there. And one more thing I want to share here, like suppose if you want to make a glide, if you want to make a glider, if you want to make an aeroplane, if you want to if you are using an bird. So bird is like something to say fly karta hai, right? So here's an option for gliding. Suppose I write here ki glide for 4 seconds at random position. So whenever I click this, you can see my sprite is gliding. It is something like, you have heard the name glider. So it's gliding. So किसी भी रैंडम पोजीशन को वो ग्लाइड करेगा फॉर 4 सेकंड एंड वंस यू चेंज द नंबर फ्रॉम 4 to 10 देन सी द ड्यूरेशन विल इंक्रीज मींस अब वो 10 सेकंड तक ग्लाइड करेगा ऑलराइट सो हियर यू कैन यूज दिस टाइप्स ऑफ ब्लॉक्स आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीट दिस आल्सो एंड हियर इफ यू एक्सप्लोर वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ ब्लॉक्स इन द मोशन ब्लॉक सो मोशन ब्लॉक इज ओनली यूज फॉर टू प्रोवाइड मोशन मूवमेंट फाइन नाउ If you can see the look block, look is just basically for looks. If you want to say something, if your character want to say something, so you can use these type of blocks. Like if I says think for 2 seconds, when I click this, you can see there's a message for 2 seconds appear. It appear for 2 seconds. You can reduce the time or you can increase the time according to your requirement. So if I write here, hello NCERT. So you can see here, it's like hello NCERT for 4 seconds. And then after 4 seconds, it will disappear. So if you are making a project in which two characters are talking with each other, something like you are, if you want to create a story, then you can use these type of blocks. So these blocks are only used for looks. Fine. So here we have a lot of options. Like if you want to hide the character, suppose if you want to hide the character, if you want to show the character, so you can use these buttons, show or hide. So whenever I click this button, my character hides from here. Fine. Now if you want to show, then click on the show. And here my sprite is available. So these type of blocks you can use during your project. Suppose you are making a game or a project when two objects collide with each other, then it disappear. For disappearing, you use the hide option. Then here we have more number of options are like if you want to change the color, if you want to change the color by how much percent. So you can change the color if you want to make this type of objects. Nice. If you want to make some funny characters, like if you want to some make funny images, so you can use these type of blocks. So it completely depends on your practice, like how much you are practicing the blocks. So moving on, we have the third block, that is a sound block that we have already used in the previous session. Here you can use sound, you want to use your own voice, you want to add MP3 songs, then you can use the sound block. So here we have some different blocks for sound option. Now the fourth one, event. So as we have discussed in the previous slide, event is just a block whenever you want to start a program, whenever you want to start a block program. So this is, we use, every time we use these blocks at the starting, to start a event. Suppose I have made a program in which whenever I click my space button, then my program start. For that, what we will do, we'll use a block. Here you can see the second block. There's an option. Whenever I click the space button, जब भी मैं अपने लैपटॉप का स्पेस बटन क्लिक करूंगा तभी मेरी गेम स्टार्ट होनी चाहिए. Fine. So I'll show you demo. कि I have put a program here कि whenever I press the space button, then मेरा जो sprite है वो move करना चाहिए. है ना? So here now what I'm doing, I'm just pressing my space button. Now you can see. मेरा कैरेक्टर मूव हुआ सो दैट मीन्स यू कैन यूज योर एक्सटर्नल डिवाइस एक्सटर्नल बटन्स नॉट ओनली द स्क्रीन अगर अपने लैपटॉप के कोई एक्सटर्नल बटन्स यू वांट टू यूज सो आप इस ऑप्शन का यूज कर सकते हैं यू कैन यूज द ऑप्शन ऑफ दिस इवेंट ब्लॉक एंड हियर वन थिंग मोर दैट आई वांट टू ऐड कि नॉट ओनली द स्पेस बटन इफ यू वांट टू यूज एनी अदर बटन फ्रॉम योर लैपटॉप सपोज इफ आई वांट टू डिजाइन अ गेम एंड आई वांट टू कंट्रोल द गेम बाय यूजिंग द WASD बटन और इफ आई वांट टू यूज द इफ आई वांट टू कंट्रोल द कैरेक्टर विद माय लेफ्ट एरो राइट एरो डाउन एरो एंड अप एरो सो आई कैन यूज द ऑप्शन फ्रॉम हियर लाइक वी हैव यूज ABCD और यू कैन सी हियर वी हैव द ऑप्शन ऑफ अप एरो डाउन एरो right arrow and left arrow. So you can use any button from your laptop. Right. So here in a similar way, if we explore more, we have a lot of options here for the event. So I'll delete this block. Now, let's talk about the control option. So here's the fifth option, that is control. So the name indicates control means it's jo aapka character hai, that is controlled by something. Suppose I want to make a project in which I want ki jo mera character hai that should move और वो कितने बार मूव होना चाहिए, इट मूव्स 10 टाइम्स 20 टाइम्स, दैट मींस मैं उसमें कंट्रोल सेट कर रहा हूँ। कंट्रोलिंग समथिंग लाइक, इसको हम प्री डिफाइन करते हैं, पहले से ही सेट करते हैं कि इतने बार ही चलना चाहिए, व्हेन एवर आई क्लिक वंस, मैं एक बार क्लिक करूँ और वो इतने नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स रिपीट होना चाहिए, राइट। फॉर दैट कंट्रोलेशन व्हाट वी डू, वी हैव डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ ब्लॉक्स, लाइक वी हैव वेट ब्लॉक। वेट ब्लॉक मींस इट शुड वेट फॉर 1 second, 2 second, 10 second और एन नंबर ऑफ सेकेंड्स। नाउ वी हैव अ रिपीट ब्लॉक। रिपीट ब्लॉक इज सिमिलर कि if I want to repeat my program 20 times, 30 times, if I want to repeat a set of numbers, a set of blocks, like suppose if I have used 2 blocks and I want these 2 blocks have repeat multiple times, you know? So I can use this repeat block and I can change the number. Instead of 10, I can use any number, 65, 62, any number. So it depends on your program, like what you exactly want to make. Then here, in the similar way, we have a repeat block, then we have a forever block. Now, the difference between the repeat block and the forever block is, in the forever block, there is no option for, just a second, yeah. Now you can see, there's a difference between the repeat block and the forever block is, in repeat block, you can set the number of repetition. You can set the number of repetition, but in the forever block, it means infinite. There is no end. That's the difference between these 2 blocks. Fine. Then we have some conditional blocks. Condition block means if else conditions. You have heard about in your aapne pehle suna bhi hoga in your programming books, or agar 11th 12th mein hai ya you are college level, you have heard in the C programming language if condition, else conditions, while condition, loop condition, you know, loop. So ye kuch words aapne sune honge in the programming language. Similarly here we have a block, that is if block or if else block. The function is same as we are learning in the programming language. The function is same. Now what exactly they do here, humne isko yahan pe replace kar diya hai with the block. So here if else means basically suppose I have a condition or like a true or false. Agar main koi statement batata hu, suppose for example I say ki if I have a 5 rupee coin, right, if I have a 5 rupee coin and I have to buy something, I have to buy a chocolate, right? So there will be 2 conditions, either the chocolate jo hai wo 5 rupees ki aayegi or chocolate 10 rupees ki aayegi. Agar wo chocolate 5 rupees ki hai, that means mere paas 5 rupees hai, that condition is true, so I'll use this condition. And if the condition is false, matlab agar wahan pe jo condition false hai, matlab chocolate agar 10 rupees ki hai aur mere paas 5 rupees hai, matlab main usko nahi le sakta, so in that case I'll use the this else wala block. Ya to if, ya to else, ya to haan, ya to na, true or false. For we have 2 conditions, so that's why we use these two, this block. Fine. So to know these blocks more in better way, so what we have to do, we have to try these blocks in our programming. So jab hum isko karenge side by side, while we, you know, while doing this, while using these blocks in the program, utna hi acche se hame isko samajh mein aayega how to use the proper block at a proper place. Fine. So we'll tell in detail about these blocks when we do the programming. Now here you can see we have one more block, that is repeat until. Repeat until means there's a condition ki repeat hona chahiye jab tak. We have set a condition ki repeat till when. Suppose I have set a condition ki repeat these blocks when the number reaches 20. When the number reaches to 20, jaise 20 pahunchta hai, it should stop. So we have already applied a condition. So here you can use these type of blocks for the conditions. So suppose if I use this block and I want to add here, this is the, you can see here, if I want to add a operational block, this is the operational block, and I use this mathematical operation here. I think you have seen the symbol. Ye hamara jo symbol aap yahan dekh rahe hain, we use the symbol in mathematics, less than or greater than, right? And if suppose if I write here 30, so that means mera jo repeat wala block hai, that will repeat, kitne baar repeat hoga, jab tak ki jo number hai 50 se ye kam nahi ho rahi hai, fulfill nahi ho jata, theek hai. So on that case we will use this block. Now to understand better what we have to do, we have to make a program and we'll apply this block on and that program, and then hum wahan pe acche samajh mein aayega how we can use this block. Fine. So this is our control block, and here in control we have a lot of options. If I say, see here, when I start a clone, this is something new. And you know that clone means something we are repeating, or we are making a multiple images. Suppose I am making a game, or I am making a animation story where suppose I have a gun and I want to shoot. So what will happen? जो हमारा बुलेट होता है, we have a bullet, it comes out from the gun, and उसमें क्या होता है कि एक single gun, single bullet जब from gun से बाहर आता है, then if you want, if I want to shoot multiple times, then हमारे पास number of multiple bullets आते हैं gun से बाहर, right? So multiple bullets का मतलब we are making a clone, we are making a clone of that bullet. For making a clone, we use this block. When I start a clone means whenever I start a clone, then what will happen? Iske clones bante jayenge, right? So here I'll show you. Whenever I start, So this is the second block, that is create a clone of myself. Means whenever I click this block, the second is this one. You can see this is the clone of my sprite. Again, when I click this block, you can see. Here's a one more clone. So here what I'm doing, I'm just clicking it one by one, and then you can see multiple clones of my sprite. Now if I put this block inside a loop, that means inside a repeat block, then what will happen? It make multiple clones. Fine. So suppose if I use a repeat block, if I use a repeat block here, if I use a repeat block and I put the create a clone of myself in the repeat block, and if I write here five times, suppose I write here five times, then what will happen? When I click this block, it make five clone of myself. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So these are the existing existing sprites. So here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this block helps me to make my clone. Jitna bhi mujhe chahiye, it makes according to that. So you can use all these blocks together to make something new program. Aisa kuch aap new bana sakte hain by using such type of blocks. So I'll delete this block from here. I'll delete this block, and then in the control section, here's the last block which I'm talking about. This is the block when we used it to stop the program. So whenever I want to use the block, whenever you want to stop the program, I'll use these type of blocks. Fine. So this is all about control section. Now we'll talk about in detail about the sensor. So you know, the students who are watching this session, do you know how many sensors we have in our body? In human body, how many sensors we have? So in the biology, I think I've heard about that we have 5 sense of organs, something we use, nose, ear, skin, tongue, you know, to smell, to touch, to feel, to look. So these are the different 5 sense of organs in our body. In the similar way, in robots, in robotics, in robot, you know, a robot like Sophia, or we can say we have different robots. So in robots, we have different types of sensors. What exactly the sensors do? They sense the environment. Suppose if a robot is here, and you know, आपने देखा होगा in the bank, in the hospital, कहीं पे अगर fire अगर आता है, आग लग जाती है, so what exactly happens? Alarm indicates. That means that sensor sense the heat. उसने क्या किया? Heat को sense किया. In the same way, if a robot is standing here, उसके सामने कुछ चीज आती है, तो robot उसको sense कर लेता है by using a ultrasonic sensor. So these are different types of sensors जो हमारे robots में होते हैं. That is similar to हमारे human body की जो sensors हैं, वैसे ही same to same हमारे robots पे भी sensors होते हैं, right? So here, if you are talking about sensors, तो these are sensor block. Sensor block means if your program want to send something. Suppose if I move my cursor and I take my cursor over this sprite, means this sprite will sense my cursor. For that, I'll use this block. To touch mouse pointer. So whenever my sprite touches the mouse pointer, it sends, and it sends a signal. है ना? जैसे इसने मेरे mouse pointer को sense किया, it sends a signal. So in the similar way, आप अगर और detail में जाएंगे, so here we have other blocks also. Like here we have color in touching. Suppose whenever I touches this orange color, or whenever I touch the green color, it the my program sends a signal. Fine. So ये ब्लॉक्स हम कब सीखेंगे, जब हम कोई प्रोग्राम बनाएंगे, हम जब प्रोग्रामिंग बनाएंगे तब हम उसके बारे में अच्छे से और डिटेल में सीखेंगे. Cool. So I'll delete this block here. Now this is distance to mouse pointer, means this sensor block helps in measuring the distance. मैं अपना कर्सर जहां भी लेके जाऊंगा, इफ दिस ब्लॉक विल सेंस द डिस्टेंस. फाइन, देन हियर वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ ब्लॉक्स, लाइक वी हैव की स्पेस बटन इज प्रेस्ड. व्हेनेवर माय स्पेस बटन इज प्रेस्ड, देन इट सेंस द स्पेस बटन कि अच्छा किसी ने स्पेस बटन को प्रेस किया है. ऑलराइट, हियर इन द सिमिलर वे वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ सेंसिंग ब्लॉक्स हियर. नाउ व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू एक्सप्लोर दीज ब्लॉक्स. After this session, go open your Scratch software and try all these blocks which I have covered here. But jo nahi samajh mein aata, you can ask me in the next session, or you can ask me at any time. We have already shared a link with you, the tech mail ID. You can ask your questions over there. If you have any technical problem related to software, related to programming, you can ask me over the tech ID. So here you can see the third last, that is a operational block. So basically, operational block means if I want to do some operations, as I already mentioned earlier, if I want to make a calculator, I want to make calculation. मुझे calculator बनाना है अपने school teacher के लिए, और मुझे उसमें काफी सारे functions in add करने हैं. Just suppose I want to add addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, less than, greater than, equal. So ऐसे बहुत सारे mathematical functions we have in our mathematics calculator, right? So you can, if you want, you can use these blocks. Here you can see we have addition. Addition block, we have subtraction block, we have multiplication. Then if you want to use a random number, hum maths mein padhte hain ki what are random numbers, select na. So here you can see we have a random number also. Like suppose if I want to use random number between 1 to 10, so mera system, mera program automatically random number select karega from 1 to 10, like 2, 5, 6, 7, any number. In a similar way, if I want to add two numbers, I'll write here 3 and I'll write here 4. So result mein apne aap mujhe 7 de dega. So that blocks we use for operations. Now here, if you want to add more, like if you want to learn more, like greater than, less than. So here we have an option for less than and greater than that I already show you. Just a second, I'll delete these extra blocks. Now here you can see we have some less than, greater than blocks are here. Like this is the less than, greater than, or equal. So these are the compare blocks we use for comparing. Similar way, आपने अपने maths के subject में भी देखा होगा कि when we compare two numbers, which one is greater, which one is less, so we use these type of blocks. Then we have some operational blocks here, like and, or, जो हम अपने engineering में basically हम पढ़ते हैं थे. Right now, these are the blocks which you use for comparing, right? So here we have a lot of blocks, just go and explore. Now, the top most, जो मुझे सबसे अच्छा लगता है block, that is a variable block. And we have heard the name variable. Variable is something that varies, right? So where we use variable block, क्योंकि बहुत से बच्चों जो मेरे से मतलब जिन मेरे से touch में है, उनका बहुत interest होता है to learn about the variable block. Why so? Because by using variable block, we make score in our game. We make timers in our game. है ना, हम टाइमर्स बनाते हैं कि टाइमर काउंट चलना चाहिए, स्कोर कि मेरा स्कोर कितना हुआ है. तो इन सब चीजों को यूज करने के लिए वी यूज वेरिएबल ब्लॉक. एंड वेरिएबल ब्लॉक, आई विल शो यू हाउ टू मेक अ वेरिएबल ब्लॉक. जस्ट आई विल रिफ्रेश दिस पेज एंड आई विल शो यू. सो सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू मेक अ टाइमर, राइट? सो वट आई विल डू, सबसे पहले हम क्या करेंगे, विल गो इन द मेक अ वेरिएबल, मीन्स आई वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट अ टाइमर. सो आई विल क्लिक ऑन द मेक अ वेरिएबल हियर. I'll write the name of my variable. My variable name is timer. So I'll write here t, just a second. T-I-M-E-R, just a second. I think it's not taking the word right now, but no problem. I'll explain it by using the name of my variable. Suppose the name of the, instead of timer, I'll use my variable. So first of all, what we'll do, we'll use set my variable to 0. Suppose my name of the variable is 0, and I'll use change by my variable by 10. Let's, I think my, I'll do one thing. I'll tell you after some time, just give me a second, how to make a timer. Then here, the last option, that is my block. So you can see when I click the my block, the pink block, nothing is there. Why so? So my block we use, suppose if I want to create my own programming blocks, right? You have seen that these are the predefined blocks jo pehle se hi Scratch software ke andar already available hain. Now I want to create my own block. Main khud ka apna kuch banana chahta hu, apna khud ka block banana chahta hu. So uske liye I'll use my block. So aap yahan pe my block mein jaake apna khud ka desire, aap jo khud ka banana chahte hain, khud se apna block bana sakte hain. And you can name it anything, you can use any image. So it completely depends on you. Either you want to make a text based, you want to make a numerical based. जैसा आप चाहते हैं आप खुद का कुछ नया इन्वेंट कर सकते हैं. That's for that we use my block. So these are the blocks that we use in the Scratch. I hope you understand all the function of all blocks. Now what you have to do, you have to practice by your own. You have to test and run all the blocks. Whenever you're making a program, आप जब भी कोई प्रोग्राम बना रहे हैं आपको उसके अंदर सारे ब्लॉक्स जहाँ जिसके यूज होते हैं आप उसको यूज कीजिए एंड क्रिएट योर ओन प्रोजेक्ट. नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड या सो हियर आई हैव कवर्ड ऑल द ब्लॉक्स लाइक वी हैव कवर्ड मोशन ब्लॉक, वी हैव व्हाट इज लुक्स ब्लॉक, व्हाई वी यूज साउंड ब्लॉक, व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ इवेंट ब्लॉक्स. सो वी हैव कवर्ड ऑल दिस ब्लॉक्स लाइक हाउ टू यूज कंट्रोल ब्लॉक एंड सेंसिंग ब्लॉक. Yeah, over to Chitra, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you so much, sir, for clearly explaining us the differentiation between each blocks and their applications. I hope everybody are clear with it and will do practice on it right away. And yes, if you want to explore more of the gamings, we have it here for you. So if you go to this link, which is already in the YouTube description of this video, you will have four different games where you can practice it. You can see how it has been built, what is the process, and also the step by step where the blocks has been logically put into. You can first see, analyze it, and start duplicating it. That is how you will understand how to create your own games. Once you start doing or repeating whatever is there, you will start understanding the logic behind each different blocks, and then once you know the different ideations, you can come up with your own ideas and create your own game and give it to the students or the teachers or anybody and create your own project, put it on the Scratch platform, put it in the competitions. And yeah, there are n number of ways that you can explore and practice with Scratch. And these are the four games that you can see here. And all the four games are very unique, and that also gives some model and education out of it. It's not like a bland game where you just put a basket and put a ball inside. No, there is a logic behind each and every game which gives some message out of it. For example, say the aquatic animals, you will have to know how important aquatic animals are for us and how to save them, what are the problems that they are having, and also trees, our lifeline. Again, we all know that trees are very, very important, and you will also get to know how to make people realize they're important through your game. Dow's wildfire, we know that wildfires are everywhere these days. Once in a year, it happens in every country, and not only in the lesser way. So again, how to douse this wildfire? We have it over here. Ozone game, how to protect our ozone with games. I mean, students will be easily able to understand the social coils, the environmental coils behind these games, but in a fun learning way. So that is the intention of these four games. Please go back and check step by step.
Yes, sir. Yes. So thank you, Chitra ma'am, for explaining all these four projects. So students, what you have to do, you just have to download these pre-baked programs. Actually, we have already here we upload some programs for you. Now I'm going to show you one of the project from here. Now what you have to do, basically, as you have seen on your screen, just you have to download the four projects, the Scratch projects, and then when you download the four projects on your computer, and just remind ki aapne usko kahan pe save kiya hai, and then come to your software, and here you can see there's an option for file in the top. click on that, and here we have a second option that is load from your computer. So now what you have to do, you have to click on the load from your computer and just search the path where you have saved the game. So I have saved the game in the day 3. Here's the first game, that is Save the Aquatic Animal. So I'm going to open that project. So I'm just helping you in how to open the project. Then what you have to do, you have to check all the games and you have to learn, or you have to explore more over there. Fine. Now this is our project. Now you can see here, this is the programming. We have already made a programming for you. Now what you have to do, you have to just change the numbers, change the values. See, है ना, आपको क्या करना है, just को changes कर करके देखने की, अच्छा इसको ये करने से ऐसा होता है, ये करने से ऐसा होता है. So you have to learn by yourself. So this is just your homework. So you have to learn it by yourself, है ना. So we have already made a program for you. Now I'm going to show you how it works. So here we have basically the name of the project is Save the Aquatic Animal. You can see the background is of water, and here you can see some black spots. Basically, these are the black spots. These are the we can say oil. Have you ever seen कि जो हमारी बड़ी-बड़ी industries होती हैं, घर का जो हमारा waste जो होता है ना, what we do, we always throw all the things in the ocean. So at the end, what happens कि हमारा जो ocean life है, वो अभी danger में आ रही है, ना? Because the oil is there, crude oil is there, and you have seen कि बड़े-बड़े oceans के अंदर petroleum से हम oil निकाल रहे हैं. So what exactly happening over there? हमारे जो fishing, हमारे जो aquatic animal life है, उनको damage हो रहा है दिन पे दिन, वो है ना. तो for that उस scenario हमने क्या किया, we have created a game on scratch to save the fish. So here when I click the green flag, now you can see here's my fish. Now I'm going to use my keyboards, my arrow buttons of my laptop. Now I can control it left, right, up and down. Now what I have to do, I have to save the fish from the crude oil, or we can say the oil, and I have to reach the destination. So whenever my fish touches the black oil, it again comes to its original position. So this is the original position of my fish. So jab bhi meri fish isko touch karegi, wo fir se usi position pe aa jayegi. Now what exactly I have to do, mujhe apni fish ko is black cross ke paas leke jana hai. Fine. So I have to save my fish from the crude oil. So hum isko leke jayenge, jaise isko touch karega, dekhiye touch karte hi wo apne fir se same उसी पाथ पे चले गई. सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट इंटरेस्टिंग गेम्स फ्रॉम आवर टॉपिक. सो बेसिकली अभी मैं आपको इसको एंड पार्ट पे लेके जाता हूं, देन वी मूव फॉरवर्ड जस्ट अ सेकंड. सो हियर यू कैन सी मस्ट फाइनली माय फिश रीच्ड एट इट्स डेस्टिनेशन. यू हैव सेव्ड द फिश. दिस इज अ ऑप्शन जो हमने लुक्स में सीखा था कि कैसे हम इस मैसेज को लेके आ सकते हैं. सो this is our first project. In a similar way, if you want to make more projects, just go over the link and direct download the three other projects and just try by yourself. Fine. So that is right now we have 4. Okay. So just a second. Again, I'm going to share my screen.
Sir, this fish game is really yeah. interesting. एंड हमें बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस क्वेरीज रिसीव हुए हैं रिगार्डिंग दीज ब्लॉक्स. सो वंस यू फिनिश द एक्सप्लेनेशन, हम कुछ सवालों का जवाब देने की कोशिश करेंगे.
Sure. And one more thing I want to add, as I already mentioned the previous session, like we have a there's a page, that's a government page, Atal Innovation Mission, जो हमारा एक government body है, उनका एक page है, that is planetcode.in, from where you can learn to how to design these type of games. Because government ने हमारे लिए free portal available किया है, जहाँ से हम और scratch के बारे में जान सकते हैं और वहाँ से उसके बारे में और अच्छे-अच्छे games बनाना सीख सकते हैं, और वो completely free of cost है. So, and if you are a teacher, if you are a student, try कि हम अपने students को भी यही same scratch platform के बारे में बताएं, उनको भी ऐसे ही interesting games related to STEM उनको भी हम सिखाएं, so that वो भी अपने class में ऐसे ही बहुत अच्छी-अच्छी games आपस में share करें और दूसरों के ना help करें to design such type of projects. So, I'm just switching to PPT just a second. Yeah. So we'll share the link. I hope you can will receive the link over the description. आपको description आपको link मिल गया होगा.
जी.
And here, yeah. So yeah. So this is your homework. What you have to do, you just download all the games and try by yourself. Now, time for question answers. So as I already mentioned, if you have any doubt related to these games, you can just reach to us. If you have any problem, sir, मुझे sprite download करने में issue हो रहा है, या मैंने अगर कोई picture download करी from the Google, but उसका background साथ में आ रहा है, how to remove the background, something like कुछ अगर query है, you can reach us to at tech@learninglinksindia.org. Or even if you want to explore more, as I already mentioned, the website planetcode.in, that is the Atal Innovation Mission's portal, from where you can learn more about the Scratch programming, right? And if you like our session, if you want to review or you want to say any feedback, you can just give us the feedback over the link also. Thank you.
Ji, thank you, sir. Okay, many of the students, viewers are asking where is the link. तो हम आप सभी को बता दें कि डिस्क्रिप्शन में इस वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में लिंक को लगाया गया है और आप वहां पर उसे क्लिक करके जानकारी पा सकते हैं. इसके अलावा एक टेक्निकल ग्लिच हो गया था तो इस सेशन के दो पार्ट्स में अभी ये अपलोड हुआ है, लेकिन थोड़ी देर में ये पूरा सेशन अपलोड कर दिया जाएगा हमारे यूट्यूब चैनल NCERT ऑफिशियल पर और आप इसे देख सकते हैं और सर ने जो भी प्रोग्रामिंग ब्लॉक्स के बारे में बताया है वो आप एक बार फिर से समझ सकते हैं. सो सॉरी फॉर द इनकन्वीनियंस एंड लेट्स बिगिन विद योर क्वेश्चंस. आपने बहुत सारे सवाल पूछे हैं तो आइए शुरू करते हैं. सबसे पहले सर धारामी पूछ रहे हैं कि जो स्क्रैच ऐप है, अगर उस पर कोई प्रोजेक्ट सेव करते हैं तो उसको ओपन करने के लिए और रन करने के लिए क्या स्क्रैच ऐप ही इस्तेमाल किया जा सकता है या किसी और ऐप में भी उसे रन किया जा सकता है?
Good. So basically, if you have designed an app or if you designed a game or project on Scratch, then if you want to again open the Scratch, अगर आप Scratch project को फिर से open करना चाहते हैं तो आपको Scratch ही use करना पड़ेगा. जो जैसे मैंने अभी ये fish वाली game open की ना, तो first load computer में जाने के बाद हमने उस project को open किया, तो this is the process. आपको अपने same project को open करने के लिए you have to copy the same, you have to follow the same.
ओके सर जसबीर पूछ रहे हैं कि क्या हम स्क्रैच प्राइमरी क्लासेस के लिए भी इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं?
Yes, for the primary class, if say I talks about the grade second or third, then there's an application Scratch Junior. Scratch Junior early age के लिए हम use कर सकते हैं, but yes, in most of the students I have seen कि third या fourth age class में ही बच्चे Scratch work करना शुरू कर देते हैं.
Okay, so there's this question which has been asked by many viewers. So Hazina, Rashmi and Madhurima, they're all asking that when we save our project, it gets saved with the .sb3 extension. So is there any provision to save our Scratch program in the video format or MP4 format?
Okay. So for that question, I would like to answer. See, suppose I'll just give you an example. My name is Neeraj and my surname is Sharma. And there's another person, his name is Anurag and his surname is Kumar. So the thing is ki sabhi ke name ke saath mein surname hota hai jisse hum usko distinguish kar pate hain ki that this the person, this the person, hai na, hum distinguish karte hain. So the similar way of my example leta hu for music ka. So whenever I save my music, uska jo extension hota hai wo save hota hai .mp3. हम कोई वीडियो सेव करते तो उसका एक्सटेंशन होता है .mp4, अगर आपने देखा होगा, या कभी आप ऑनलाइन घर पे अगर पढ़ रहे हैं, आपके टीचर को असाइनमेंट शेयर करते हैं, तो वो आपको PDF की फॉर्म में या वर्ड की फॉर्म में आता है, जो .pdf, .txt ऐसे फॉर्मेट्स में आता है. सो हर फाइल का अपना अपना खुद का एक फॉर्मेट होता है. इन द सिमिलर वे हमारा जो गेम है उसका जो फॉर्मेट है दैट इज .sb3.
ओके ऑल राइट सर. नित्या इज आस्किंग कैन वी क्रिएट अ होल एनिमेटेड स्टोरी ऑफ अराउंड 7 to 8 मिनट्स यूजिंग स्क्रैच?
यस नित्या, यू कैन डू. बेसिकली इफ यू वांट टू टेक मोर टाइम यू कैन, बट द थिंग इज कि वहां पे हमारा जो प्रोग्रामिंग के जो ब्लॉक्स हैं वो थोड़े से एक्सटेंड हो जाएंगे या हमें ज्यादा उस पे कंटेंट अप्लाई करना होगा, बट यू कैन मेक 2 to 3 और मोर, है ना, आप कितना भी टाइम उसको यूज कर सकते हैं.
ओके Alright, so Stalin is asking, so dear sir, after I saved my Scratch project, it's not opening and it's saying that it's not a valid bitmap file and the format is currently not supporting. So what should I do?
Okay, so I just want to ask, are you saving the game or are you saving the picture? Because the bitmap is basically for the picture, it's a format of picture, not for the gaming. So just do one thing. If you are saving a game, the format is .sp3. And if you are saving a picture, then our picture bitmap may be saved. Both have different extensions. Hmm. Right.
I would like to add on to this. Yeah, and if you have saved this file, and if you just double click on it, it might take you to different, you know, Adobe or some other application, and it might defaultly not open it. So the best way to open any of your save file is go to Scratch, know where is the location of your save file. So you can go and just click on it, and it will correctly open in the application.
Okay. All right. Stalin, I hope you've got the answer you were expecting. Okay, ma'am, sir, there's another question, and the person is asking that he's using Scratch, but he's not getting ideas over there. So what should I do?
Okay, so Chetana, would you like to answer?
Definitely. So first of all, when you have zero idea about Scratch application, all that you have to do is, there is something called tutorials right about the Scratch application. Like, you know, in the toolbar, you will get this option, tutorial. So where you can learn from basics to the, you know, little of extension version of Scratch by the end, so that you will get an idea of how to create your own greeting cards, how to create your own concert animations, hiding and showing your characters, and multiple such things you can learn only with these tutorials, and can jump to gaming and higher level of technical animations, games, projects. And later also, we also have something called planetcode.in that we described before, where you will get a lot of games to create yourself, all the ideas. You see, once you start creating such projects, you'll have your own ideas, thinking, okay, this is how the idea should be. This is how I should create my own games.
Okay. All right.
So the first one is the tutorials, which are on the Scratch. And the second one is planetcode.in, two options.
Sure. Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, ma'am, for being here, for answering the questions of so many viewers. And once again, I would like to tell all the viewers that the link is in the description. Please click on the link, raise your questions regarding the programming and the software. So we'll be waiting for all your questions, and we try every day to answer the queries you are raising. Okay, this is a 10-day training, and all the sessions are being uploaded on the YouTube channel NCERT Official. Today was the third day, and on the last day, that will be 16th of July, there will be an assignment, and on the basis of the assessment of the assignment, you'll be issued certificate for this training. So all the very best, and spread this message further. Thank you so much, sir and ma'am, once again for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you to all the viewers for participating. We'll meet again tomorrow at same time, 4 o'clock at same place, that is PM eVidya, channel number 6 to channel number 12. Till then, stay healthy, stay happy. Thank you. Namaste.